Hey y'all, what's up real quick? I didn't want to have to jump on here, but since this woman beater want to keep talking shit, I'm finna clean you up real quick. Tank. I want to tell you something. I am so happy that you think I look like a French bulldog and you consider me ugly, because you beat up just so you consider cute. I'm glad I'm ugly to you. That's one. And then two, go win some belts. You steady up on here tweeting. Is you that f***ing lonely? Go and find you some friends. Oh, and I want to ask you a question. I thought women was supposed to suck. Why is you on Ryan so hard?
Oh, Ryan test just came back that he wasn't dirty.
And he ain't even tested the B sample yet. Why are you so worried about?
And run off 2 seconds. Okay.
He had the press conference.
My presents, he's my God, the one and only. This is going to be a good time. I want everyone to be a part of it. So at this time, I want to introduce to you the man from Salida Promotions. He is Mr. Big Time Boxing USA on the zone. And you can see this fight on the zone July 27th. Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together for Dimitri Salida.
Thank you, Ronnie. Big Time Boxing is back July 27th, right here from the Caesars Arena, live on the zone. That's the Lucha Shoes. Fights for a 4th division world title. I'm just gonna list some of those shields and customers. He's a 2-time world title medalist, 3-division undisputed world champion, something that she's done faster than any man or woman based on the sport. She won the ESPY award in 2023, being the only female boxer ever in the history of the sport to win that award. And if successful, when successful, she's going to follow in the footsteps of Roy Jones Jr., be the only fighter in the history of the sport, be the only middleweight in the history of the sport to fight the MMA world title. We as Salida Promotions are committed to develop talent locally and internationally, and we're committed to working with every promoter in the sport of boxing. I want to thank Eye of the Tiger and Mr. Stefan for making this fight happen. We're going to announce the undercard next week, which is going to feature some of the best fighters for fighting conditioning from around the world in the most competitive fights. Bringing Big Time Boxing back to Detroit and making Detroit once again another world class professional boxing would not be happening with our partners that have vision, our leadership, and those people, our folks at 303 Entertainment, and most importantly, Mr. Howard Adler, who has helped us bring Big Time Boxing back to the city of Detroit, to the Caesars Arena. I'd like to invite Top Point Boxing on July 27th.
Everybody, welcome to Little Caesars Arena. Big Time Boxing is back. We are so excited to partner up with two incredible fighters. It's great to have Claressa back, and welcome Vanessa. We couldn't do it without Dimitri and Mark Taffet. 313 Presents promotes and produces 350 concerts, theatrical events, family shows, and sporting events. Every single year we entertain about 2 million people a year. This venue in particular is where a lot of incredible things happen. Of course, we have the Red Wings and Pistons. We have some amazing concerts. We had Jhené Aiko last night, completely sold out. And when we put big events like we did last year when Claressa came to town, it's what makes Little Caesars Arena one of the top 10 venues, one of the top 10 arenas in the country, in the world, every single year. So what an amazing backdrop to have an even bigger fight this year. Now, everybody knows Detroit has a very deep legacy of producing and embracing boxing champions. Last year's event was electrifying. I cannot wait to see this fight. This is going to be an incredible battle. We're very excited to have as many people as we can come out and to fill this arena, because we want to keep establishing Detroit as one of the preeminent boxing destinations in the world. We got a lot of competition, so we got to show them what we're made of here in Detroit. So welcome, can't wait for fight night, and we will see you all on July 27th. Go to 313presents.com to get tickets, and thank you very much. And of course, Howard Handler of 313. We're going to have a fight come July the 27th. And if you got $25 in your pocket, well, that's just enough to get a seat to this fight. And if you want better seats, you can get better seats. I can tell you, this young lady here, you did 12,000. I've already told Dimitri, you're about to do 19. Because we're about to turn the roof off this month, and we're going to have a good time. But in order to do that, you've got to have a good opponent. And a good opponent doesn't come trying to lose. When you speak of a record, 7-1, WBC heavyweight champion. While Claressa is moving up, she's going to come down, because they will be fighting for the WBO light heavyweight championship of the world. And before I move on to bring up our next guest, we have some boxing luminaries that are in the house. This young man fought out of the Crum Gymnasium, and he was a junior middleweight champion. One of the greatest trainers out there, the trainer for Claressa Shields, Don David. John David Jackson. Not a member of the Jackson 5, because he can fight. John David, appreciate that. And once again, when you get back to Florida, tell my friend Nate Campbell, I said hello. Most recently, the top luminaries in all of boxing gathered in Gastonia, New York, for the Boxing Hall of Fame. And a lot of times, when you look at that, it's dominated by men. Claressa's gonna knock the door down when it's her time to get in as well. But this young lady has done it for such a long time. Everyone knows her. You saw the movie, Meg Ryan played her. You know her life, because when you talk about the publicist of Hilmer Kinty, Kronk, and Thomas the Hitman Hearns, she was the lady who got the word out. One of her favorite friends is no longer with us. He was a great one, the boss, Frank Sinatra. But most recently, she was inducted into the Hall of Fame. Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together, look this way for Jackie Gowdy. Now those are the stars of the past, but what about the stars of the day? Eye of the Tiger Promotions, they get it done. And sir, I've got to say to you, you're primed for something. And I like what you've done with so many of your fighters, and I know at any time, if Eye of the Tiger fighter comes to any place, they don't come to lose or lay down, they come to win. Ladies and gentlemen, put a round of applause for the manager, the promoter, the man who knows Eye of the Tiger, Emil Estefan.
I want to thank Dimitri and Mark for doing this event. It's very, very important for boxing, the world in general, for women's boxing. We have Claressa here with all the belts, and Dimitri presented her very well. I'm here to present Vanessa, and I'm going to present her with this one belt, the WBC Heavyweight Championship. The most important belt, and that's the only one you can talk about. You're going back home in that belt. I guarantee you, you're ready to fight. And fight is going to be, and you should not lose this fight, because it's going to be the best fight of the year in 2024. That's my prediction. Going home with the belt. And the goal for us, very frankly, that I spoke to us about, is we're going to go to Detroit to take something very, very important to us. Not only the belt, but the popularity that Claressa has. All the respect for Claressa, because she's about to do this boxing somewhere else, and we bring this forward where you're from. Black people set up on. Don't miss this. And you better thank her for being here.
We just heard from the Eye of the Tiger. Now let's hear from the punch of that tiger. Now he will be here, of course, to interpret for Matt Canada with a record of 7-1, 2 knockouts. This young lady is no joke. You come up, you gotta deal with her. She brings the smoke, somebody says they got the fire. Let's find out what they have. Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together for the WBC heavyweight champion of the world, Vanessa Jalice.
J'ai hâte, ça va être un beau combat pour ceux et celles qui ne connaissent pas. Dany, c'est bien qui fonce, qui n'a pas peur, qui donne un méchant chaud, vous allez être sur le bout de chaise tout de long. Et pour ceux et celles qui ne connaissent pas, vous allez connaître mon nom à la fin, je suis bien.
So Vanessa is very excited and thankful to be here and the team that is together. We're roasting that boat more, and I know that this girl comes to fight. She comes forward, she brings the heat. And for those of you that don't remember her name today, Dany, you'll remember it for the rest of your days, because you'll be at the edge of your seat in the first second, total knockout.
Our next person that we're going to bring here is a man with a vision. And that vision is one not only of victory, but of commitment. He is Mark Taffert of Mark Taffert Media, and also a mastermind behind the career of Claressa Shields, put together. He's New York's best, but he's coming into the D to get some too. Mark, come on up.
Thank you, Ryan. Thank you very much. First of all, Jack, congratulations. I met Jackie in 1994 in my first 2 years at HBO pay-per-view when we did what turned out to be one of the greatest fights we ever had. James Tony and Roy Jones. And this one of the MGM Grand's top 50 fights in history, celebrated recently at the 100 Greatest Fights celebration in Las Vegas. And Jackie walked into a room then and made a presence known. And she does it with a little bit more grace today. But still the same, the presence has always been so. Thank you for being here, and really, hats off to all my best friends. I want to thank Dimitri, Slate Promotions, Howard Hammer, 313 Presents, and his staff. Camille.
Absolutely.
Thank you very much. Camille and I worked together many times at HBO during my career there. And he always sees it. Utmost professional, very, very hard worker, very committed, and I was very excited when I found out that he was working with Vanessa, because I knew that we would all put our best foot forward. So Camille, thanks a lot. It's great to work with you again. I want to thank Vanessa. First time we've met today, but I'm very excited because, first of all, I've always been a fan of her fights and her style. She does come to fight. She is a great ambassador for women's boxing. For the style that women's boxing wants to exhibit. For her to step up and put her WBC heavyweight championship on the line, she did not have to do this. She has the courage and she has the strength and commitment to go forward. So thanks again to Vanessa. The three greatest fighters that I ever worked with, Roy Jones, Floyd Mayweather, Claressa Shields. Talent from those fighters like no other fighter, and I've worked with the best for 25 years at HBO. Some of the greatest fighters in sports history. This woman makes history in every fight. We said from day one when she turned pro that our goal would be to make history in every fight. In 2003, Roy Jones became the first man in 100 years to move up from middleweight and win the heavyweight championship of the world. On July 27th, Claressa Shields. Attempts to be the second person to do that and the first woman in history to move from middleweight to heavyweight and win that great title. And it's not something she necessarily envisioned when she began her career, but it's going to be an historic fourth weight division for Claressa, and we're thrilled again to make history and have her continue to expand her legacy in this sport on her way to the Boxing Hall of Fame someday. We know we're going to have a great event. We know that Claressa will bring all 16 of her belts, as you see them here today. That whole collection will be on display in Detroit on July 27th. We had a magnificent event a year ago here in Detroit. We couldn't wait to come back again. And we know we'll have another very special one. I would like to bring up now and introduce to you a woman who's having one heck of a year in 2024. She won an MMA fight in February. She won a boxing fight in July. Before the year's over, she'll have a theatrical film about her life that everyone will be able to see across this country and around the world. Very, very special, and she has a lot of history still to make, and she's committed to making it. She wakes up every day thinking about children, thinking about young women. She has a foundation that supports the betterment of those kids. She's always looking to expand and increase the role of women in sports. She stands for equality in women's sports, and she'll never sit. She'll always be standing until that day takes place. The two-time Olympic gold medal winner, two-division undisputed world champion, the winner of Best Fighter of the Year last year in the ESPYs. She beat the three top guys. She actually wants to be in the ring, but we have to hold her back a little from that sometimes. And as I said, soon to be the holder of a fourth weight division and on her way to a third weight division undisputed champion. One and only Michigan's best and Flint's favorite, Claressa Shields.
Professional fight for the undisputed title. I fought against her. Was it the sixth? The sixth fight. So we did these pretty early. And after that, I fought against the best. When you go on box rank and you look at who people have fought and you look at all these knockouts, one thing that we did not have the pleasure of doing with my career was padding my record. We didn't pad my record with girls who had losing records to be here on the main stage and make you guys think that I'm the best women's fighter of the world. I'm the best women's fighter of the world because I beat the best. That's it. Three different weight classes, I beat the best. Going for a fourth weight class, July 27th. You know, what else do you have to do for to do this? I walk in here with 16 belts, 2 Olympic gold medals, the ESPY, and all people want to talk about is starting. It's hard work, dedication, discipline, prayer, belief. If you don't believe in yourself, then who will? So I believe in me, and I believe that July 27th, I will be, I hate to say the word, but heavyweight champion of the world. Because as you can see, I'm not Asian heavyweight. We can see that. And that's okay. But for the sport of women's boxing, I will go miles and miles and miles to prove that we deserve equality, we deserve to pay equal opportunities, and equal fight venues. I have been saying for years that I can fill up stadiums like Little Caesars, Madison Square Garden, T-Mobile Arena. I've been saying for years. They never gave me the opportunity. Now I had the opportunity once to get 12,000 people. That was my first time. I believe that July 27th, there's going to be 19,000 people. It's going to be a great fight. And I look forward to facing off with Vanessa. Vanessa, if you guys have seen her fight, she does come forward. She does, she's a headhunter. She's big, she throws her weight around. And I just can't wait to bring Vanessa up to me. So I can show her, you big and everything. You're a little strong, but it hasn't been many who I'm fought. It hasn't been big, it hasn't been strong. So, I'm in the gym putting on some weight for you. I squatted 230 yesterday. I've been benching 185 just so I can make sure I can keep this big girl above me. So make sure all you guys come to the fight July 27th. We have some great VIP options where you can be able to walk up whichever belt that you choose to be 16. And then I'll be going meet and greets and everything. So make sure you guys come, celebrate, and let me show you what women's boxing is really about, because it's really about great competition, great competitors, and about proving who's really the best and not just talking about it. Sorry, one last thing. So my boxing career is far from over. I have within 8 years, but we're starting a business party. So T-Rex Promotions is up and running, and I have signed my first fighter. My first fighter name is Samantha Kitchen. I met Samantha back when I was getting ready for 2016 Olympics. Women's boxing only has 3 weight classes, 165, 132, and 112. And me and Samantha were actually both going to fight at the same weight class. We were friends, very, very close. That is my sister in Christ. But she said that God came to her and told her that I was going to win the gold medal. So she said, I'm going to go down to 132 pounds. And she did it. And Samantha is built like me. Okay? And Samantha went down to 132. She fought against the vets in the amateurs. And now she's turned pro. She's done well for her career so far. I believe that under my tutelage that she can beat some of the best welterweights in the world today. So, she's not here, but you guys have a warm welcome to Samantha. And she's fighting the life of the best one of her time. And her, it's not her pro debut because she's been fighting, but she's making her pro debut with T-Rex Promotions and hopefully by some new promotions July 27th.
Let's say it one more time for GWOAT. All the time. Now she gets an opportunity to move up 2 weight classes. 160, that's the current. 168, 175, take on this young lady right here, who is serious. I don't know if you were watching Claressa, but I was watching Vanessa. And Vanessa is ready. Remember, we're talking two champions. Two champions. Championship pedigree, championship belt, and no one has come here to lose. This one here ain't never lost it. Never lost. This one here, the most complete combat fighter in the world. That's MMA and boxing. This one here ain't backing down. I looked at the videotape. You coming for real, ain't you? At this time, I'm going to ask some questions, and after I ask a few questions, we're going to go to questions from the media. So if you have some questions, we'll have you take a microphone and we'll have you talk to Claressa or Vanessa. Vanessa? Young? Okay, that's right. I thought I was on the line for a second. Let me ask you this, Vanessa. You get the call. Camille tells you you have the opportunity to fight the face of boxing. A lot of people don't want to say just the face of women's boxing. She's the face of boxing. How many current champions do you see as announcers and doing fights, doing color commentary, not past champions, current champions? You can see her on the zone. Even when she's not fighting, she's talking. But when you knew that you were having an opportunity to take on the face of boxing, what was your immediate impressions?
On a go de fight, je suis vraiment content et on y va, c'est une belle opportunité. Je veux pas dire popularité, c'est ce qu'on va venir chercher là pour la France. On vient pour la France, cette popularité-là, on vient faire un gros combat. Je suis championne du monde dans les weights, ça va être un gros combat, c'est une opportunité qu'on refuse pas.
You said let's go, I wanna go get that popularity in the person I choose to face a woman's boxing. Why? Let's go.
She says, let's go. She's the face of women's boxing. She has what you want. A lot of people have what you want. Some are too light to box. They have a big mouth and they say they want to fight you, but we ain't trying to go down, we're trying to go up. When you found out, not only were you going to fight, and you and I have had these thoughts prior to it, we know sometimes making weight can be a little hard. Now you get to have all the sweet potato pie you want, but at the same time, you're on a mission, and that's to win. I know you're taking her seriously. You know that she can punch, but why her? It could have been a lot of other people, but why her?
Well, you know.
It's on.
Hello. I see when we got the call, you know, to fight at heavyweight. At first, I was telling Dimitri and Mark, like, I was already going to 54. I was like, my ready to go to 47. I had to get this. Dimitri said the best Peter's 12, you know, and I was like, but we did try to get a fight with Natasha Jones at 154, offer a lot of money, turned it down. So, what can we do but act in fights? And rather they say yes, but they always say no. Even with Baumgartner, he let her know too, if you really want to smoke, let's make it happen. All jokes, all just cop on it, not for real. So, where else would I go? I beat everybody at 60. There's only Franchon in Savannah at 168. Franchon and Savannah won't fight against each other again. So he was really 175 and up. So when we got the call, I really had no interest in fighting at 75. I actually lose weight in power, but I don't mind it coming territory. But then when they showed me footage of Vanessa, and I see how tough she was, how big she was, and just seeing her nice pretty belt, I was like, I turned down that, you know. I was willing to go down and tell the girls to come up, but I'm like, what if I go up? And then when they told me it was heavyweight, I was like, I never dreamed of being heavyweight champion of the world ever. That's Muhammad Ali type stuff.
Let me put it to you this way. Yeah. They tried it one time with a name that we spoke about later. They were talking about her and Von Ford. She wouldn't climb the ladder. You do. And that's the most impressive thing about what you're doing. People don't understand. There are levels to what we do. She's on a completely different level. What threat does she pose to you?
You know what? She posts a lot of threads. She's shorter. So I know she's going to have her game plan as she strictly come forward to get on the inside. She has punching power. I don't think none of these girls are fast as me. None of these girls got the skills that I got. But size does matter in fights. I think this fight, what people are overlooking is that I have to kill myself to make weight too. Now that I don't, I think all that people talking about that I don't have knockout power will be put to a rest. Because I'm going to be very, very strong and very, very fueled up for this fight, and I don't have to starve. So we'll see. My full body at 175, and just as she's coming in strong and fast, I'm going to be strong and fast too. So I think July 27th will be fireworks, and we'll be in each other's face, in each other's chest. But I just know how to dig deep, and I don't think people have been through the pain that I've been through. And it's not that it's her fault that she'll have to feel my pain, but that's just the name of the game in boxing.
Sign the contract, got to do the job.
That's all.
Where's the shields? Let's go back to Vanessa. Vanessa, what are we missing? Not only in your fighting, not only in your character, not only that you fight for Quebec and all of Canada, but what are we missing in looking at you? Knowing that you're an opponent, knowing that you're a champion, but more importantly, there are 19,000 people here at Little Caesars Arena. 313 presents The Zone, The Eye of the Tiger, Dimitri Salida Promotions, Big Time Boxing. Are you ready for this big stage? I know that Camille puts on big shows, but are you ready for all of the people, majority of the audience, saying Claressa, saying GWOAT, is this moment going to be too big for you? And if so, tell me why, but if not, tell me why.
Celui-là, ben, ça en est juste un plus, mais que je vais revenir encore. Puis la foule, c'est juste l'excitation que ça emmène du combat, mais je sais que le Québec, peu importe si je m'en viens en plus 3 et demi, je sais que le Québec va être là derrière moi, puis je suis très, très encouragée, je la sens cette énergie-là, et elle va tout donner.
See what you don't see from her is that you see her power, you see her strength, but you don't see her heart. She's been through so much for her life, just like Claressa, that she fuels her. Little Caesars Arena is going to be big, a lot of people, a lot of excitement, a lot of fans screaming. This is going to bring more excitement to fight. But she's going to have the whole of Quebec in mind, because Quebec knows her story, and she's going to bring that belt back home.
All right, we hear it all happens here, July 27th. It's for all the belts, WBC, Heavyweight Championship. WBO Light Heavyweight Championship, and going up against the GWOAT. Tickets are on sale, $25. Your lowest ticket that you can get. Tell your friends. Everybody's got to see some history that will be on the line. It's never happened in the history of time. Tell everybody you were there the night that Claressa Shields did what the GWOAT wants to do. And normally what the GWOAT wants to do is done. Now let's, if you have any questions from our media members, raise your hand and we'll take 2 questions. And after that, we will have a face-off of the fighters. Any questions for Claressa? Yes, sir. Right here.
Hi, my name is Isaiah Hall. I'm with WBIB 144. Yesterday, so you were out in Flint for another media event. You seemed to carry Flint where we go. Do you expect the city of Flint to come out and in big numbers for this fight? And as well, do you see yourself as a role model to the people of Flint?
Thank you. I do expect Flint to come out. I expect them from all over the U.S. to come out, but especially
my hometown because I do so much for the city. I inspire so many kids. And you can talk about Flint. You ask anybody about Flint over the past couple of years, they bring up the water crisis. And then after the water crisis, they bring up the rest of the shoes. So I am one of the positive things about that's in Flint. And I carry myself with a lot of class, a lot of success. I keep us on the map in a good way. You know, as far as being a role model, I grew up with parents that told me who was I say and not what I do. But for me, I really want to tell people that look up to me that long as you are being your true self, you can never feel bad about that. I have accepted that everyone in life is different. You know, it's some champions in my life who don't trash talk, and then you have me that do trash talk. There's some who don't fight very well but talk a lot, and then there's some that fight very good but don't talk. So it's just, I'm a different type of champion. And if anybody wants to get behind me and follow me and be a part of the GWOAT journey, they have to accept me and, you know, grow with me and be with me. But I am who I am, and God has blessed me to be great. And hey, I'm from Flint, Michigan, and Flint has done so much for me, so I want to continue to represent them. And hopefully they get behind me and, you know, support as well.
Thank you. Next question, Frank Garza.
Latino Detroit. This question goes to Camille and to Vanessa. June 20th, 1980, Montreal, Canada. One of the greatest fights ever to take place in the history of boxing took place there at the Olympic Arena. Do you see the same magic? Do you see the same result? Is that why you came to Detroit? And I don't mean to mention the fight.
Sugar Ray Leonard will murder the winner.
Oui, exactement. Puis c'est un rêve qui a été réalisé le 7 mars, mais en étant pas plus haut. Puis c'est encore beaucoup plus près que je pense. Puis je vais faire probablement le plus beau cadeau parce que ma fête c'est le 20 juillet. Donc je vais faire le plus beau cadeau le 27 pour créer mon histoire à moi.
Absolutely, you know, it's history in the making. To be able to be inspired by an event, you know, the history of Montreal, Quebec, and boxing goes very deep. And it was, when she won this belt, it was a dream. But now she wants to take it further. On July 20th, it's her birthday, so she's going to wait for 7 days to give herself a second beautiful birthday. And you in the making.
All right, we've heard from the fighters, and now it's time for them to face off. I know we're in the home of the Detroit Red Wings, but this is not Quebec against Detroit. This is, of course, boxing. Ladies, madame, please come to the board and have a face-off so we will get a chance to see you. The fight is coming up July the 27th.
It's live.
Here at Little C's Arena. 313.
What's she on, though? I don't know.
The Lion, the Tiger, the Zone. So Leader Promotions and Big Time Boxing, they will be fighting for the WBO Light Heavyweight Championship of the World. Choose a belt. The ring one looks good. It's unified. It's that. And I'm telling you right now, it's going to be a great time for the one, the only, quote, she is the only woman to win two Olympics and two Olympics.
I don't know what she owns.
She is the only woman to be undisputed in two different weight classes. She ain't afraid. Ain't nobody backing down. It's time to put up a shut up, get down and throw down. There's about to be a beat down in Motown. It's happening July 27th. Make sure you're around. Ladies and gentlemen, this concludes our press conference. We'll have an opportunity for one-on-one with television, newspaper, and radio networks. Our fighters have spoken. Now it's
time. Girl, like she really going to slow down. I love it. Was that a photo?
Yeah,
it was a high.
I got it.
Awesome. I got my water. You want to stay online?
Absolutely. Yes. Before we do that, let's do. Sorry, guys. We didn't have my contact. We didn't have Mark.
Y'all, she done fucked up. She done fucked up big time. She done fucked up. You can end that.
You are horrible!